Howdy, friends and neighbors. It's time once again for Honky Tonk Heroes, Volume 5. Here at Eclectic American Roots, our shows explore a variety of roots music from rockabilly and blues to western swing, plus jazz, R&B, and country, Tex-Mex, hillbilly, and Americana too. Our Honky Tonk Heroes format captures dozens of like-minded musicians who share with you their personal musical influences. On each show, our own roots music historian and rockabilly legend, Big Sandy, compiles vintage videos to help illustrate where this great music came from. So, sit back and relax, or get up and dance. Eclectic American Roots is on the air. Let's start right off with Big Sandy's personal time machine with an intimate look back at artists from the golden age of honky tonk. Here's Big Sandy.
Hello, friends. Big Sandy here, and I thank you for stopping by for our fifth installment in the Honky Tonk Heroes series. I'll be covering a wide variety of artists, ranging from the most popular and influential to the lesser known, but no less engaging. I'll also be pushing the boundaries a little bit stylistically, a wide variety of music to cover in a little time, so let's get started right now. First up, the Missouri-born Jan Howard. After spending some time throughout the Midwest, Jan gradually worked her way out to the West Coast and met the wonderful Win Stewart, and through him also met the legendary songwriter Harlan Howard, who she soon married. This is a song that Jan recorded for Challenge Records, a song written by Harlan Howard and Fuzzy Owen. Make her feel welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Jan Howard.
I had the key to heaven when we married, and for a while I brought you happiness, but now your love for me is dead and buried, and every night you share another's kiss, and I'd rather be the one you slip around with than be the one whose dream of love is gone. Yes, I'd rather be the one you spend your time with than be the one at home all
life.
that was Jacksonville, Florida TV personality Virginia Adder, appearing on a local television production, The Glenn Reeves Show, doing a Connie Smith tune. Love it all. And now, our mystery artist. I posted a picture of this artist on social media over the last couple days. Some of you sent in your guesses as to who this artist might be. No one got it. Any more guesses? He first appeared on the Grand Ole Opry in the early 60s, in 1966, became an Opry member, recorded for several years for Capitol Records, and ended up working behind the scenes as an A&R man. Ladies and gentlemen, today's mystery artist, Ray Pillow.
It's nice of you to be making conversation. I've been here all night and hitting the juice pretty hard. You wonder if my pride's in hibernation. But this always happens when my baby has trouble staying in her own backyard. My pride has gone with the wine, gone with the wine. My usual self has left me for a time. But when the wrath of the great is my only escape, don't be alarmed, it's just gone with the wine. I know that I am a getting more plowed than the bottom 40. But when I come in here, her memory's so easy to lose. You wonder if my pride's in hibernation. But this always happens when my baby has trouble staying in her own backyard. My pride has gone with the wine, gone with the wine. The jukebox seems to help out with the dime. But when the wrath of the great is my only escape, don't be alarmed, it's just gone with the wine. Gone with the wine.
Badcock will treat you right.
I am George Jones.
And I'm Tammy Wynette. Here at our home at the Old Plantation Music Park in Lakeland, Florida, we count on Badcock.
You know, we're confident of quality merchandise from Badcock.
Take it from us. Badcock will treat you right.
You say I ought to know that he don't love me anymore, and I'll have to let him go. You say you're gonna take him, but I don't think you can, 'cause you ain't woman enough to take my man. Women like you, they're a dime a dozen. You can buy 'em anywhere. For you to get the move over, and I'm gonna stand right here in
introduction needed there, of course. But let's give her one anyway. The great and still wonderful Loretta Lynn. Friends, I'll be back in just a little bit with something a little bit outside of the usual here on Honky Tonk Heroes.
Jimmy Dale Richardson brings new life to the obscure art of traditional honky tonk, rockabilly, and jump blues. Jimmy Dale's roots come from his grandfather, Hubert Pierce, who is cousins with both Webb Pierce and the Wilburn brothers. And he played honky tonks in the 40s, 50s, and 60s in Oklahoma, Texas, and Louisiana. Jimmy Dale writes and arranges his own music. And in 2019, Jimmy became the Rockabilly Male Award winner at the Ameripolitan Music Awards in Memphis. Jimmy has toured with Reverend Horton Heat, among many others. So let's watch and see who has influenced Jimmy Dale Richardson. Hint, it's one of the all-time greats of honky tonk.
For me, my honky tonk hero would have to be Farron Young. With his crooning style, is amazing. But his wind-up and haunting delivery is what really sends it for me.
Well, me and my baby, we're going steady. We ain't married, but we're getting ready to tie the knot. I'm gonna make her my own. On the phone, 'cause she's my baby, she's going steady with me.
That's what I can really relate to with his singing style and his music. And then he was also just a very human person. He was funny, you know, his antics. And then somebody that shows realism. He went through depression, just like a lot of people do. But he is one of my great inspirations. So it has to be Farron Young. Now here's a song that I wrote in Farron style and how he influenced me. This one's called Memory Lane.
I'm taking a walk down memory lane, just wishing that I had you back again. Same. That's why I'm walking down. him all along, but our love remains. That's why I'm walking down memory lane. I'll just keep walking down memory lane.
Canadian Brad Lewis came to Southern California at an early age, watching live broadcasts on Sundays like Hank Snow and Hank Williams. After high school, he was a regular performer at California honky tonks like Georgia's Roundup Club, the Foothill, and many others. In the mid-80s, he started his own group and took over Dale Watson's regular gig at the Blue Bayou. The California Country Music Association named him Band of the Year and Male Vocalist of the Year. Lazy Brad Lewis has joined Will Ray's band, the Gila Monsters, who were regular performers at the Palomino Club, too. Through it all, Brad Lewis has been influenced by a very famous Texas songwriter. Let's let Brad tell the story.
Hey, thank you, Christopher. Brad Lewis here. Talk about one of my biggest honky tonk heroes here in this episode of Honky Tonk Heroes. Guy that started in Texas. Made a big splash in Nashville for many years and sold a ton of hits. Finally got tired of Nashville because he couldn't get his own band going. Went back to Texas. Started the Outlaw scene. Called some of his buddies, you know, Waylon, and said, hey, I know you don't like that Nashville sound. Get out here in Texas. We're gonna cause our own scene out here. I found a great place out here. People love our music. And that's just how it was. And then pretty soon Willie Nelson was Shotgun Willie. He was the red-headed stranger. Pretty soon he was singing with everybody. He did country albums with Hank Snow, Ray Price. He did jazz albums, gospel albums. But the main thing was his humanitarianism. This guy saved some farmers, saved horses, biodiesel. He's a pioneer on a lot of fronts. Probably one of the greatest Americans that is also a honky tonk hero. That's right, Willie Nelson. Some of his big hits from Nashville in the very first year, Crazy, Four Walls, Nightlife, and one of my favorites right here. Ain't it funny how time slips away? Well, hello there. Thank you.
Video host spends a lot of time in the old bunkhouse researching vintage videos with his crack team of international cowgirls. They keep him busy from dusk to dawn. Let's see if Big Sandy has time to share some more clips with us. Big Sandy?
And I'm back, this time with a musical variety that we have yet to touch on any of the Eclectic American Roots presentations, Cajun music. This time in particular, Cajun honky tonk. The swamplands of Louisiana have always been fertile ground for the mixing of cultures of all kinds, and the Cajun musicians of the early to mid-20th century often found themselves playing at dance halls, mixing a wide variety of styles, including country music, and interacting with touring country artists passing through the region. The results were often beautiful, as you'll see here in this clip from the 1963 film Down Home Music. Ladies and gentlemen, Shorty LeBlanc and his Sugar Bees.
They lived right down the road from us in a shack, just like our shack. We worked in the fields together, and we learned to count on each other. When you live off the land, you don't have the time to think about another man's color. The cotton was high and the corn was growing fine, but that was another place and another time. I remember the best times of all, when Saturday rolled around. We'd always stop by Willie's house and say, do y'all need anything from town? He'd say no, but why don't y'all stop on your way back home? And I'll get Laura May to cook up some corn pone. The cotton was high and the corn was growing fine, but that was another place and another time. They took back what they'd given, and we all knew we'd have to move if we was gonna make a living. So we all moved on and went our separate ways. Sure was hard to say goodbye to Willie and Laura May. The cotton was high and the corn was growing fine, but that was another place. From them no more, till I saw Willie downtown the other day. I said, y'all stop by tonight, and we can sit down and eat a bite. We'd love to see your children and Laura May. He shook his head real slow and spoke with his eyes so kind. This is another place and another time.
And that was Texas-born Jamie Ryan performing a Tony Joe White song. Jamie got her start recording demos for Starday Records and soon met and married Charlie Dick, the widower of Patsy Cline. Dun, da, da, dun. Now we're going to take a look at the woman known as the Queen of Country Music, Kitty Wills. Kitty's big breakthrough came in 1952 when she recorded It Wasn't God Who Made Honky Tonk Angels, which was an answer song to Hank Thompson's Wild Side of Life, which we'll hear about later in the show. But here she is now performing a timeless classic, a Jimmy Work song, Making Believe. Ladies and gentlemen, the Queen of Country Music, Kitty Wills.
Miss Kitty Wills! Dream.
can't hold you close when you're not with me. You're somebody's love. You'll never be mine. Making believe I'll spend my lifetime.
This old smoke-filled bar is something I'm not used to, but I gave up my home to see you satisfied, and I just called to let you know where I'll be living. It's not much, but I feel welcome here inside. I've got swinging doors, a jukebox, and a bar stool. And my new home has a flashing neon sign. Stop by and see me anytime you want to, 'cause I'm always here at home till closing time. Crazy, and I've got everything it takes to lose my mind. And in here, the atmosphere's just right for heartaches. And thanks to you, I'm always here till closing time. And I've got swinging doors, a jukebox, and a bar stool. And my new home has a flashing neon sign. Stop by and see me anytime you want to, 'cause I'm always here at home till closing time. I'm always here at home till closing time.
Stop the world and have a Coke. Coke has the taste you never get tired of. Coke after Coke after Coke. Things go better with Coke.
Of course, old Waylon is singing about Coca-Cola there. Personally, I sing about Coke Zero, or Honky Tonk Zeros, as we call them around these parts. Right before that, one of the greatest honky tonk heroes of all time, a man who's been on this show a few times, Merle Haggard. Friends, if you're enjoying today's presentation, please take a moment to visit our virtual tip jar at StellarJAX.com or Venmo at Jax Hideaway. That's Jax with an X. I'll be back in a flash with many more Honky Tonk Heroes.
Next up, a red-haired rockabilly songstress from Southern California, singer Amber Fox. She grew up in a musical family with their North Carolina musical roots. Dad would be picking the guitar and singing while Grandpa would be playing the banjo. Music was a staple all through her young life. For the past 20 years, Amber has been performing swing, jazz, rockabilly, and old-time Americana music. Her passion has taken Amber all over the world, playing festivals in the US, Australia, and even a tour in Brazil. In England, she performed with the Fly Right Boys, featuring the incredible guitar picker T.K. Smith at a rockabilly rave. Amber recently opened for Larry Collins at a Stellar Showcase and sang a tribute to his sister, the late Lori Collins. For Honky Tonk Heroes, Amber has chosen the King of Western Swing. Tell us all about it, Amber.
Well, Christopher, thank you so much for that awesome introduction. I appreciate it, as always, and I'm really excited to be on the show today. So today we're talking about heroes. And of course, we all have a bunch of different musical heroes, but today I have chosen one that really inspires me, and his name is Bob Wills. Bob Wills was a happy guy. Anybody that's ever seen him on stage when he's performing, he doesn't take things super serious, which is very similar to me when I'm on stage. I really have a lot of fun, and I don't want to take things too serious. It takes the fun out of it, right? The other thing is when Bob Wills plays, you want to tap your feet and you want to have fun. And after all, he was the king of American Western swing. And that music is just like, you want to get out and just start dancing and have fun. It's happy music. The interesting part, there's a couple of really neat stories about Bob Wills as a child. And he struggled a lot as well, but he was very musical as a child because of his father, who also played the fiddle very well. He was in a lot of competitions, but they also were sharecroppers, and they cropped cotton. So they had a family, they had a farm, and they had a lot of music, which is very similar to the way I grew up. We grew up with a lot of music all the time, with the banjo and the guitar, and it was just something in my life that I loved. Then at 16 years old, he actually left home and he started hopping freight trains for a couple years. Super fascinating. Kind of became like a hobo a little bit. So he decided to leave that life when he almost died from jumping a freight train, and a police officer found him, and he changed his life. Decided to become a barber, of all things, to feed his family. So he had a family. Became a barber, and he played fiddle part-time and was on the radio and had all these different bands because he loved the music, and he knew one day he would make it big, which is fantastic. So he brought Tommy Duncan on board. Again, Tommy Duncan, one of my favorite singers, with such smooth, beautiful vocals, and that was in the 30s, and they formed the famous Texas Playboys. So Bob loved jazz. Believe it or not, I mean, you could hear it in his music. But one really neat story that really stuck with me is his daughter talked about him talking about this story where he would get on horseback when he was young, and he would go for 30 miles on horseback to go see none other than Bessie Smith, who he said was one of the most fantastic singers that he had ever seen and performed. So I love that story. I think it's really cool and it sticks with me. And of course, Merle Haggard would sneak out of his house, another hero of mine and everybody else's, to go see Bob Wills play. So one last quick story before we get into the video clip is, very interesting. I live here in Anaheim. I grew up in Orange County, but my mom used to bring me to this interesting house down the street from me, actually, where I live right now. It was an antique house, and they sold antiques when I was little. It was super creepy, actually. Come to find out, it was called the Harmony Ballroom here in Anaheim, super close to Linda's Doll Hut, the famous doll hut here in Anaheim. And Bob Wills used to go perform there. Unfortunately, it was tore down in the 90s, but I have this flyer and I have the house where Bob Wills used to perform super close to my house. And I've been in that house when I was little in the 80s. So pretty cool. Anyway, let's get going on this clip. It's called Riding On Down. I hope you guys enjoy it. I don't think it's ever been recorded. I found it on a DVD. Remember DVDs back in the day? And I loved the song so much that we've just been playing it ever since. So enjoy this clip. See you guys out there. See you on stage. And thank you so much for having me on, Christopher. Thank you.
Just for fun, here's a clip of Bob Wills in an old B Western helping out on the same song, Riding On Down.
Mr. Thompson, have you seen Joe?
Yes, I saw him about an hour ago. He was looking sad, riding along, and singing this song. Goodbye, gal, goodbye, baby. You're gonna miss me someday, maybe, but I'm riding on down. Yes, I'm riding on down. Well, I don't know where I'm going, but I know I'm somewhere bound. I've been good, I've been true, I've been everything to you, that's why I'm riding on down, yes, riding on down. I'm tired of you kicking my poor heart around.
Kyle Eldridge is a singer, songwriter, and guitar player in Louisville, Kentucky. Kyle writes and performs, combining Western swing, rockabilly, and honky tonk. A bona fide three-time Ameripolitan nominee, Kyle has released multiple albums of original material and recorded at studios like Dale Watson's Watson Studio in Memphis, Big Tone Studios in Bristol, and Deke Dickerson Studios in Los Angeles. His flying fingers on guitar have been compared to his idol, Joe Mathus. Kyle Eldridge and the Kentucky Cowhands play a truly authentic slice of vintage-style American music. Their music will remind you of drive-in diners, classic convertibles, and the laid-back Southern attitude we all love. See for yourself. Kyle, who influenced your playing?
As far as musical influences go, for me, my heroes cover many different genres. You know, Western swing, rockabilly, country and Western, honky-tonk. I mean, just a lot of different players and a lot of different instruments, vocalists. But, you know, a mainstay of my style is... people who know me know, of course, it's a lot of guitar players. Joe Mathus, Larry Collins, Merle Travis, and, you know, the styles they developed over the years. And, you know, as far as people like Joe Mathus goes and Jimmy Bryant, you know, they were fiddle players, and they brought a lot of their techniques from the fiddle to the guitar, not just in terms of playing fiddle tunes, but also in terms of arranging. And you see that a lot with the way that Joe Mathus played with Larry Collins, with their twin guitar instrumentals, and the way he played with Merle Travis as well, just in terms of arranging and the harmony involved in doing that. And a technique used on the fiddle a lot is a thing called double stops, which is playing two notes at the same time or two melody lines at the same time, melody and the harmony together. And it's definitely a tough technique to use, but boy, it sure is a lot of fun and sounds great if you can pull it off. I'm a little sloppy at it sometimes, but it's just cool to hear that sound of, you know, two lines at the same time. The clip you're about to see is my attempt at that on a song called "The Women of Piccolo," and it's a long story behind that song. It's an instrumental from a movie soundtrack from, I want to say, the late 80s or early 90s, from a movie called Porco Rosso, about a World War I flying ace, and it's a cartoon movie, and there's a song in that movie, and I heard it and thought, man, wouldn't it be cool to, you know, like, make a twin guitar song out of this somehow, and me being only one person, and thought, well, I could record it twice and do both parts, or I could just do the double stops and learn it that way. That way I can maybe try to pull it off live. And that's what you're about to see here, my attempt at playing that live with double stops. So again, The Women of Piccolo, it is on my new album called Riverboat Gambler on Swell Tune Records. It's out now. Be sure to check that out as well. We'll be right back.
always a musical maverick, Hank Thompson took Western swing to a new big band level with his twin fiddle and steel guitar attack. With his Brazos Valley Boys, he won every Western swing band contest for 13 years, from 53 to 65. With his 12-piece band, he was dubbed King of Western Swing, as were Spade Cooley and Bob Wills.
They call me Mr. Honky Tonk, the King of Western Swing. There's something in that music that I love to pick and sing. When the band starts playing, you can hear them fiddles ring. They call me Mr. Honky Tonk, the King of Western Swing. When I hear that steel guitar, it makes me feel so proud. Pretty girls a-dancing, just listen to that crowd. From Tennessee to Texas, when they hear me do my thing, they call me Mr. Honky Tonk, the King of Western Swing.
Here is how he compared to most honky tonk stars of his time. He was the first country act to play Las Vegas in 1960. His iconic album, Live at the Golden Nugget in Las Vegas, was the first live album by any country artist. He was the first country entertainer to travel with his own light and sound system, the first to have a corporate sponsor, and the first to record in high fidelity stereo. He was also the first to broadcast his television show in color. Hank Thompson was a pilot and was the first country artist to fly himself to his gigs.
Hank, they tell me one reason you can get in as many as 250 personal appearances a year is because you fly your own plane.
That's right, Rod. I have a Cessna 310 aircraft that I manage to put about $500 a year on. And at over 200 miles an hour, that's a lot of mileage.
A lot of mileage.
Hank Thompson's plane will never reach the dizzying heights he has achieved in country music. Singer, songwriter, and band leader.
Hank Thompson grew up in Waco, idolizing Western swing and country musicians like Gene Autry, Bob Wills, and Jimmy Rogers. He appeared in local talent shows and had his own local radio program. He was billed as Hank, the Hired Hand. After serving in the Navy, Thompson returned to Texas in 1943 and set about putting together a band he dubbed the Brazos Valley Boys.
Thompson Show, bringing you live the nation's favorite Hank Thompson and his Brazos Valley Boys. Now, here's Hank.
All right. I hope that all you folks liked the little cartoon for introducing our brand new series of programs on Channel 4, and this time here at 7:30 to 8 o'clock. And we'd like for you to stick around because, boy, we got lots of time here for lots of nonsense. The little tune that we just got through singing, of course, our theme song, Humpty Dumpty Heart, it's a little nursery rhyme ditty. We came along a few years later and did this one here called Rub-A-Dub-Dub. Let's try it again. Once upon a time in the nursery rhyme, three little men got lost. Like you and me, they couldn't agree, and upon the waves they tossed. Well, I sing their tune, cause I got marooned with a love I can't forget. Now the three little men just took me in on an ocean of regret. With a rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a tub, lost on the ocean blue. I'll roll like a hub, sing rub-a-dub-dub, cause you broke my heart in two. My heart is sore and I can't reach shore, and I'm drifting far away from the love I had, and I'm feeling mighty bad, and I can't go on this way. Won't you throw out the line and say you're mine and take me back again? Cause my rudder's broke and it ain't no joke. Won't you reach and pull me in with a rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a tub, lost on the ocean blue. I'll roll like a hoof, sing rub-a-dub-dub, cause you broke my heart in two. Right away, there'd never come a day when I'd reach land again.
The one-eyed door on the distant shore is now at the rainbow's end. To the three little guys, I turn my eyes, won't you tell your names to me? Now one said fate, one said hate, and the other said jealousy. With a rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a tub, lost on the ocean blue. I roll like a hoop, sing rub-a-dub-dub, 'cause you broke my heart in two.
By 1946, the singing cowboy and actor Tex Ritter had become an admirer of his, and he helped Thompson get signed with Capitol Records in 1946.
How did you get from Waco, Texas, where you started out, to Lake Tenkiller, Oklahoma?
Well, of course, that's the long story, Rod, and there's several memorable things. One, I guess, that I can recall is down there in Waco, Texas, Tex Ritter came to town, and he had a real pretty pair of white britches that I sort of admired, and I was talking to him about them, and he said, well, I'll tell you what, Hank, if you'll come out and sing a song with me tonight, I'll give you those white britches.
Well, I guess it was right paying you off in clothes, since you are famous for your wardrobe. Now, your outfits are valued at around $40,000, aren't they?
That's right, Rod, and I don't guess there's anybody any happier about it than Nudie the Tailor.
In 1948, at age 23, Thompson recorded 6 successful singles and scored big with the song Humpty Dumpty Heart.
Here's a guy I'm delighted to welcome to our show. He's got the finest Western swing band around, sings a heck of a song, and one delightful guy. Say hello to Hank Thompson and all the Brazos Valley boys.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a big ball. All the king's horses, all the king's men, together again. I've got a Humpty Dumpty heart. You dropped it and broke it apart. All the king's horses, all the king's men, could never put it together again. But when I gave to you my heart, you said that we must part. That was my doom. My heart went boom. I got a Humpty Dumpty heart. I turned your whole card upside down. Around. There's a smile upon your face while another takes my place. And now at last, dear, the truth I found. Babe, there's the green light. Pick up your heels. There'll come a day you'll know how it feels. You have your ace and trust. Be taken for a chump. Now there's the green light. Don't spin your wheel.
Looking good and sounding better.
Thank you, Jim, and certainly a pleasure to be up here with you, Hank, myself, and all the Brazos Valley boys.
You know what, I'm going to tell something on you, and we didn't rehearse this. Hank's team comprises a portion of a baseball team, and they used to travel by bus. They did. And they were playing an early morning show we used to do, and after the show, we finished the show, and Hank says, let's play some baseball. We said, why not? And so we go out to play baseball, and somebody said, now we're going to play softball or baseball. Hank said, oh, man, play baseball. I get hurt playing softball. Wait a minute, wait. Now, Hank's up to bat, right, and his drummer's pitching. He stands up there, and the first pitch, come on, whoppo, right here, you know, and it starts swelling up. The next day, he comes in to do the broadcast, and he's got a cast from here to here. Broke his cotton picking arm, but he never gets hurt playing baseball.
No, I tell you, I know him. That's the last game I played.
In 1952, Thompson recorded The Wild Side of Life, a monster hit that stayed over 3 months at number one. And it became Thompson's signature song.
You wouldn't read my letter if I wrote you. You asked me not to call you on the phone, but there's something I'm wanting to tell you, so I wrote it in the words of this song. I
the only one that ever loved you, and went back to the wild side of life. Has lured you to the places where the wine and liquor flows, where you wait to be anybody's baby and forget the truest love you'll ever know. I didn't know God made honky tonk angels. Never make a wife. You gave up the only one that ever loved you and went back to the wild side of life. And went back to the wild side of life.
The controversial song and its success inspired an answer, a recording by Kitty Wells that made her into a star. Kitty Wells was the first female artist in country music with a million-selling record.
As a favor to me, and of course I know to the folks out there, they'll love this one, would you mind doing a special song, It Wasn't God Who Made Honky Tonk Angels?
I'd love to.
Thompson also gave early breaks to musicians like guitar legend Merle Travis and female rockabilly pioneer Wanda Jackson. Wanda was only halfway through high school in 1954 when Thompson heard her on an Oklahoma City radio show and asked her to record with his band. She did for 2 years while still in high school. By the end of the decade, Jackson had become one of America's first female country and rockabilly singers. Toward the end of the 50s, Thompson began to create LPs that were more cohesive than just mere collections of singles plus filler. 1958's Dance Ranch and 1959's Songs for Rounders were Western Swing honky-tonk masterpieces. Maybe his best LP, made up of songs about the rougher, raunchier sides of life, including Cocaine Blues.
Early one morning, making my rounds, took a shot of cocaine and I shot my woman down. Went right home and I went to bed, took an 11.44 beneath my head. Woke up next morning, grabbed that gun, took a shot of cocaine and away I run. I made a good run, but I went too slow. They overtook me down in Juarez, Mexico. Sitting in the hop joint, smoking my fill, in walked the sheriff from Jericho Hill. He said, Willie Lee, your name is not Jack Brown. Why, you're the dirty hop that shot your woman down.
This record was considered very controversial within conservative country music circles at the time, and in many ways broke a lot of ground within the field. This was also his first stereo album.
You go down in Deep Ellum just to have a little fun. Better have your $15 when that policeman comes. Oh, sweet mama, papa's got them Deep Ellum blues. Oh, sweet mama, papa's got them Deep Ellum blues. Now, once I knew a preacher preached the Bible through and through. He went down in Deep Ellum, now his preaching days are through. Oh, sweet mama, papa's got them Deep Ellum blues. Oh, sweet mama, papa's got them Deep Ellum blues.
In the 60s, musical tastes were moving towards slick country pop and the electrified Bakersfield sound. So despite several more fine records, Thompson's relationship with Capitol ended in 1965. He didn't make the top 10 again until 1968's On Tap, In the Can, or In the Bottle, and also Smokey the Bar.
Smokey the Bar, lights dimly glow. It's good that way, cause heartaches don't show. Each hand holds a glass, each glass holds a beer. Jukebox records play mid sorrow and cheer. Lots of them are happy, they laugh and tell their jokes, while lots of them are here because they're just lonely folks. And then there are others whose hearts wear a scar, but you can't see them crying, it's so smoky the bar.
Thompson continued to record and tour, and his singles charted during the 70s all the way up to 1983, though he never matched the success he enjoyed in the 50s and 60s. Even after the hits dried up, he maintained a demanding concert tour schedule, playing all over the world. Thompson was elected to the Rockabilly Hall of Fame in 1961 and the Country Music Hall of Fame in 1989. Still touring, and shortly after canceling some live dates, Thompson died of lung cancer in 2007. Settle up, buckaroos, and join us again on the Honky Tonk Trail with the outlaw, Big Sandy.
Big Sandy back again. Now, in 1970, Lynn Anderson recorded a Joe South song that forever changed her career and the way that women in the country and western field figured into the mainstream. It was a huge crossover hit, especially in our family station wagon on road trips. This is most likely the biggest pop hit that you're ever going to hear on this program, but it's without a doubt a very important song in the history of country music. Here she is with her smash hit, Rose Garden. Honky Tonk Hero to millions, Lynn Anderson.
Now, here's Lynn Anderson.
I beg your pardon. I never promised you a rose garden along with the sunshine. There's gotta be a little rain sometime. When you take, you gotta give. So live and let live, or let go. Whoa, 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 whoa. I beg your pardon. Soon let you go, but there's one thing I want you to know. You better look before you leap. Still waters run deep, and there won't always be someone there to pull you out. And you know what I'm talking about. So smile for a while and let's be jolly. Love shouldn't be so melancholy. Come along. There's gotta be a little rain sometime. Thank you!
Introducing new Country Crackers. The best of Lynn Anderson. Out now from KTEL.
Almost every night I'd write a letter to my mother in old North Carolina. She'll probably cry tomorrow when the mailman leaves her out. The way my baby done me is nothing to write home about. I promised Mom I'd send her news about my baby. She was so proud her son had finally found true love. From the way things turned out, the way my baby done me is nothing to write home about. Oh yeah. Oh
and me, we'd walk these hills just reminiscing. But he can tell I'm not the same, something's missing. Lord, while I'm holding old Blue at bay, another's holding her, no doubt. The way my baby done me is nothing to write home about. The way my baby done me is nothing to write home about.
Making his debut appearance here on Honky Tonk Heroes, Dale Reeves. Dale had many hits that were more on the novelty side. I prefer the serious side of Dale Reeves. Next up, a guy that's been a longtime favorite of mine, a guy I feel doesn't always get the attention that he deserves. But a look at his body of work that he recorded over a relatively short period of time, it provides like a good look at the development of country music in the mid-20th century. Started recording Western Swing, then Hillbilly, some Rockabilly. He settled on some pretty hardcore honky-tonk. Let's take a look at him now on our local TV show, Town Hall Party. Here is Skeets McDonald.
With the click of the phone, the voice is gone and I'm all alone again. The things you say make me feel like living again. Oh, me, what a lonesome life has been. Tonight when I hold you, will it be for the last time? Is it love or a pastime? Oh, you, with a kiss goodnight, you walk from sight while the doubts come crowding in. What a lonesome life it's been. Your voice is gone and I'm all alone again. Oh, me, what a lonesome life it's been. When I call you each day, the things you say make me feel like living again. Oh, me, what a lonesome life it's been. Tonight when I hold you, will it be for the last time? With a kiss goodnight, you walk from sight while the doubts come crowding in. Oh, me, what a lonesome life it's been.
Connie, I want to ask you, what's the most exciting thing about being on the Grand Ole Opry?
Well, I think it's getting to meet all the wonderful people in country music and the members of the Opry and all the nice people that come to see the Opry.
Very well put. What are you going to sing?
Ain't Had No Lovin'.
Fine. Here's Connie Smith.
Gonna get
And with that performance, the great Connie Smith becomes one of the most featured artists to appear on all five volumes of this program, Honky Tonk Heroes. Congratulations, Connie. I should mention that Connie Smith has a brand new album out now called Cry of the Heart. And the first single, Look Out Heart, is fantastic. Way to go, Connie. Oh, Honky Tonk Heroes. Don't go away.
Adrian Ace Rice began performing and touring in the Northeast back in the 60s before his family took all his attention. Then a decade ago, Ace created Coyote Moon to continue his passion for Americana roots music. Now with 200 shows under his belt, including multiple appearances at our stellar shows, Graham Parsons Tributes, Ace still has something important to say.
Howdy, friends and neighbors. Thanks so much for having me, Christopher. It's a pleasure to be here. And my honky-tonk hero that I'd like to share with you is Graham Parsons. And Graham Parsons was a seminal figure in early country rock, but he was a true lover of traditional country music, and he influenced a lot of other musicians of the time and right up to this day, and influenced a lot of listeners, including a 16-year-old me with Sweetheart of the Rodeo album and his rendition of the great George Jones classic, You're Still on My Mind. Well, I'd never heard of George Jones before that record, but thanks to Graham, I was able to start to dig deeper into what I would call honky-tonk music. So with that, I will let the festivities continue, and thanks so much for having us.
California native K.P. Hawthorn launched her solo career with the 2006 album Lucky Girl, a recording whose tracks found their way onto TV shows like Friday Night Lights and Dawson's Creek. As a co-owner of independent record label Mule Kick Records, K.P. has helped champion other artists whose music blurs the boundaries between multiple genres. As creator and producer of the upcoming Palomino Club documentary titled Palomania, KP highlights the long-lasting reach of an historic honky-tonk music venue. KP and her husband Johnny Hawthorn have spent a dozen years weathering the ups and downs of the music industry. They've tapped into a new beginning as the Hawthorns, intersecting the worlds of rock, country, and pop. Here's their take on an early Americana icon whose own journey has inspired them.
Hey everybody, I'm KP, I'm with the Hawthorns, and we are traveling westbound on Highway 40, which is basically Route 66, and we thought this would be a nice place to stop and tell you a little bit about the Maddox Brothers and Rose, and their story. It's a big story. In the 1930s, there was a Dust Bowl. We all know about, historically, the Great Dust Bowl, the Grapes of Wrath. Hundreds of thousands of people moved from the Midwest and the South to California. And Lula Maddox and her six children were some of those people. They came to California, they hopped trains, they walked, they hitched rides along these paths we're on now. And they came to California and worked all day long in fields. They slept in ditches, irrigation ditches, and there's a train. And they made their way, and that was not the dream that Lula Maddox had for her children. She wanted something better for her children. Well, her kids were also pretty musical. So her kids started a band, and one of the brothers said, we're doing this. We're quitting this fruit picking in California in the 1930s, and young Rose was not even a teenager, and they started playing music together. They were just rowdy, and the thing is, that music that was brought from this area of the country to California, there were banjos and mandolins and things, and there was no amplification at the time. So their live band situation had to be, you know, they had all these workers coming in from the fields on the weekends to hear them play, and they had to hoot and holler and make a ruckus in order to be heard. And so when we're talking about honky tonks, the early honky tonks in California, that's how they sprouted up, was from those workers in those fields trying to burn off some steam. Anyway, time goes on. Rose Maddox and the Maddox Brothers, they are just killing it. There are thousands of people coming to see them. They have a radio circuit. They're very famous. They're called the most colorful hillbilly band in America. Their suits are made, they're some of the very first, you know, fancy rodeo suits that were made. They were made by Nathan Turk before nudie suits. And they were just amazing. They drove around California. They all followed each other in these big Cadillacs from gig to gig. And they just made a real impression. And the thing is, we don't hear a lot about Rose Maddox because they were on a record label called Four Star Records. And Four Star was a very oppressive record label and didn't allow them to grow, and, you know, as so many of the other artists did. WSM in Nashville, big radio there, had a big control over so much of the music that was coming out as country music. And here in California on the West Coast, you know, they were fighting an uphill battle. So Rose Maddox is not a well-known name, but she is a hero to people like Dolly Parton, Wanda Jackson, and so many others. And when you listen to the music that she recorded through the years, you can understand why.
Honey, baby, we'll go honky tonkin' around the town.
Here comes that honky tonkin' donkey.
Honey, baby, we'll go honky-tonkin' around the town.
Ah, yes, Jimmy, let's go.
think you're going to love them. I suggest that you go get the Johnny Whiteside book, Rambling Rose. It's her biography written by Johnny Whiteside, and it tells the story of her entire life in music, and it's just a real wonderful piece. So anyway, I hope you dig into Rose Maddox and just get some more information. It's such a beautiful story and just such a wonderful artist. And yep, we'll see you on the other side. Hi everybody. I'm going to play Philadelphia Lawyer, written by Woody Guthrie. And this was recorded by the Maddox Brothers and Rose, and also by Rose Maddox on her record One Rose. So enjoy this murder ballad. Way out in Reno, Nevada, where romance's bloom and fade, there was a great Philadelphia lawyer in love with the Hollywood maid. Come love and we'll go rambling down where the lights are bright. I'll win you a divorce from your husband and we can get married tonight. Wild Bill was a gun-toting cowboy, 10 notches were carved in his gun, and all the boys around Reno left Wild Bill's maiden alone. One night when Bill was returning from riding the range in the cold, he was thinking of his Hollywood sweetheart. Her love was as lasting as gold. As he drew near her window, two shadows he saw in the shade. 'Twas the great Philadelphia lawyer making love to his Hollywood maid. The night was as still as the desert, the moon hung high overhead. Bill listened a while through the window, he could hear every word that they said. Your hands are so pretty and lovely, your form so rare and divine. Come go with me to Philadelphia and leave this wild cowboy behind. Now tonight, back in old Pennsylvania, among all the beautiful pines, there's one less Philadelphia lawyer in old Philadelphia tonight.
The clock on the wall says it's time for another shot. And who enjoys his silver tequila more than our own patron, Big Sandy?
All right, and I'm back, Big Sandy here. And for my final round of videos, I offer you a trio of favorites. Favorites of mine, favorites of the show, favorites of yours, perhaps. I hope so. Beginning with this wonderful woman, Dolly Parton. Dolly's been featured on a couple different episodes of Honky Tonk Heroes, one of the times performing this song, but this is a different performance altogether. The song, Dumb Blonde. Now, there is a dummy in the clip right at the top. I can assure you it's not Dolly. Mm-mm. Take it away, Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton recorded a song called Dumb Blonde.
Yeah.
She is about to sing it for you.
Thank you,
right
Bobby.
Now, Dolly.
you suppose you could work us in a song about here?
We'll try to. Here's one we hope you like. Oh, I wish I could fall in line today.
I wish that I could fall in love today, but memories of you stand in the way. I wish my heart could find somebody new. It's always much too busy with the blues. I wish that I could fall in love today, but if I did, I know I wouldn't stay. You'd come between us like you always do. Somehow they never measure up to you. Each night I pray I'll wake at dawn and find another in my heart and on my mind. And I awake and hear my poor heart say, I wish that I could fall in love today.
If I could sing like that, I'd never talk another word, Ray. Wonderful.
I know where you're going, who's gonna meet you there. I know how late you'll be coming home, but guess who doesn't care. Tonight I'll step out too, since I won't be here. Happy birthday, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year. My best wishes may be early, but I'm not sticking around to bake a cake for your birthday while you're out running around. She can help you celebrate, may she bring you lots of cheer. Happy birthday, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year. You think I don't mean it, so you're gonna call my bluff. Well, I'll be busy packing while you're holding her near. Happy birthday, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year. My best wishes may be early, but I'm not sticking around to bake a cake for your birthday while you're out. She bring you lots of cheer. Happy birthday, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year. Happy birthday, Merry Christmas, and Happy, Happy New Year.
And there you have it. Dolly Parton, Ray Price, Loretta Lynn, all of them, American treasures, and all of them, honky tonk heroes. Friends, that wraps it up for me. I thank you for stopping by. And let's thank all of our wonderful guests here today. You keep those cards and letters coming, and we'll see you next time right here on Eclectic American Roots. Big Sandy signing off. Thank you so much.
That's our show. Thanks for riding along with us, and be sure to check in every Sunday for Eclectic American Roots programming at noon Pacific time. All shows are archived on YouTube at the StellarJAX channel, and we urge you to support musicians by donating to the virtual tip jar at StellarJAX.com. A little goes a long way. I'm Christopher Burkhardt of Stellar Shows and Concerts, and we'll see you next time.